Levetiracetam is a novel anticonvulsant agent used as an adjunct medication to manage partial onset, myoclonic, and generalized tonic-clonic seizures in patients with epilepsy. In this video, let's find found. What is levetiracetam? What is levetiracetam used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking levetiracetam? How does levetiracetam work? How to use levetiracetam? What is levetiracetam? Levetiracetam, sold under the brand name Keppra among others, is a medication used to treat epilepsy. It is used for partial onset, myoclonic, or tonic-clonic seizures and is taken either by mouth as an immediate or extended release formulation or by injection into a vein. Levetiracetam was approved for medical use in the United States in 1999 and is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 92nd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 7 million prescriptions. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicine. What is levetiracetam used for? Levetiracetam is indicated as an adjunctive therapy in the treatment of partial onset seizures in epileptic patients who are 1 month of age and older. Additionally, it is indicated as an adjunct in the treatment of myoclonic seizures in patients with juvenile myoclonic epilepsy who are 12 years of age and older, and in primary generalized tonic-clonic seizures in patients with idiopathic generalized epilepsy who are 6 years of age and older. Levetiracetam is also available as an orally dissolvable tablet that is indicated as an adjunct in the treatment of partial onset seizures in patients with epilepsy who are 4 years of age and weigh more than 20 kilograms. Contraindication. Levetiracetam injection is contraindicated in patients with a hypersensitivity to levetiracetam. Reactions have included anaphylaxis and angioedema. Side effects. The most common adverse effects of levetiracetam treatment include CNS effects such as somnolence, decreased energy, headache, dizziness, mood swings, and coordination difficulties. These adverse effects are most pronounced in the first month of therapy. About 4% of patients dropped out of pre-approval clinical trials due to these side effects. Pharmacodynamic. Levetiracetam appears to prevent seizure activity via the selective inhibition of hyper-synchronized epileptiform burst firing without affecting normal neuronal transmission, though the exact mechanism through which this occurs is unclear. The therapeutic index of levetiracetam is wide, making it relatively unique amongst other anti-epileptic medications. Anti-epileptic drugs, including levetiracetam, may increase the risk of suicidal ideation or behavior. Patients taking levetiracetam should be monitored for the emergence or worsening of depressive symptoms, suicidal ideation, and behavioral abnormalities. Mechanism of action. The exact mechanism through which levetiracetam exerts its anti-epileptic effects is unclear, but is thought to be unique amongst other anti-epileptic medications. Current knowledge suggests that levetiracetam binding to synaptic vesicle protein 2A, SV2A, is a key driver of its action. SV2A is a membrane-bound protein that is found on synaptic vesicles and is ubiquitous throughout the CNS. It appears to play a role in vesicle exocytosis and in the modulation of synaptic transmission by increasing the available amount of secretory vesicles available for neurotransmission. Stimulation of presynaptic SV2A by levetiracetam may inhibit neurotransmitter release, but this action does not appear to affect normal neurotransmission. This has led to the suggestion that levetiracetam exclusively modulates the function of SV2A only under pathophysiological conditions. Levetiracetam and related analogs showed a relation between affinity for SV2A and antiepileptic potency, further suggesting that action at this site contributes to the antiepileptic activity of the drug. Levetiracetam has also been shown to indirectly affect GABAergic neurotransmission, despite having no direct effect on GABAergic or glutamatergic receptors, and modulate ionic currents. Similarly, levetiracetam has been shown in vitro to inhibit N-type calcium channels. How, or even if, these actions are implicated in its anti-epileptic action have yet to be elucidated. Half-life. The plasma half-life of levetiracetam is 6 to 8 hours and is not affected by dose or repeat administration. Half-life is increased in the elderly by about 40% and those with renal impairment. Dose. Myoclonic seizures. Immediate release, Keppra, Spritam 500 mg 4/POQ12HR, may increase Q2 week by 500 mg per dose to recommended dose of 1,500 mg Q12HR. Effectiveness of doses than 3,000 mg per day has not been adequately studied. Partial onset seizure. Indicated for treatment of partial onset seizures. Need for oral loading dose not established. Immediate release, Keppra, Spritam 500 mg POQ12HR, may increase a week by 500 mg per dose, not to exceed 3,000 mg per day. Extended release, Keppra XR or Elepsia XR 1,000 mg POQ day, may increase Q2 week by 1,000 mg/day, not to exceed 3,000 mg per day. 400 mg Q12HR, may increase Q2 week by 500 mg per dose, not to exceed 3,000 mg per day. Primary generalized tonic-clonic seizures. Need for oral loading dose not established. Immediate release, Keppra, Spritam 500 mg 4/POQ12HR, may increase Q2 week by 500 mg per dose to recommended dose of 1,500 mg Q12HR. Effectiveness of doses greater than 3,000 mg per day has not been adequately studied. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category C. Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. Comments: monotherapy is preferred whenever possible. That's all the information about levetiracetam we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.